Hello everyone, my name is Iris France, 我叫林婉如. Today we're going to talk about the production possibility curve, also known as the PPC. Bottom line first, production possibility curve outlines the maximum amount of goods and services that a society can produce given all its resources. And often you see production possibility curve is sometimes a straight line, it's sometimes bow-shaped. In this clip, I'm going to explain why. Bottom line is this, if you have a society with the same kind of labors or same kind of resource, then you're going to see a straight production possibility curve. And if you have a society with more diversity, you have different kinds of workers, then your production possibility curve will be bow-shaped. And you already know that bow-shaped production possibility curve is more realistic. Now we start an example with the society with the same kind of resource. So we have three engineers in this society, and each engineer can produce either one pizza or three robots in 1 hour. So not both. You can imagine that if the engineer is producing pizza, then the engineer cannot produce robots at that time. So with that information and the three engineers, we are ready to sketch our production possibility curve. Let's put pizza on the horizontal axis and robots on the vertical axis. Suppose we have all engineers producing only pizza, then we can see that each engineer is going to produce one pizza, and together we're going to have three pizzas. Now, suppose we have all the engineers producing only robots, then we're going to have 3 times 3, 9 robots and no pizza. Connecting the two lines, now we will have the production possibility curve. You can imagine that we can choose basically any point on this production possibility curve and produce at that point. And we can calculate the slope of the production possibility curve. So the slope of this curve will be the rise over the run. So from point A to point B, you can see the rise is from 9 to 0, so the rise is negative 9. And the run is from 0 to 3, so the run is 3. And therefore, your slope is equal to negative 9 divided by 3, which is negative 3. And the slope of this production possibility curve has a meaning. It is actually the opportunity cost of one pizza in terms of robot. So you can see the opportunity cost of one pizza is equal to three robots. And the reason why you see a negative sign is this. To produce one pizza, you have to sacrifice three robots. Meaning for each engineer, if you are producing the pizza, you're producing one pizza, then you're not producing the robots. And therefore you have to sacrifice three robots. So the slope of the production possibility curve tells you the opportunity cost of one pizza in terms of the robot. And in this case, the opportunity cost of one pizza is three robots. And also let's take a look at the production possibility curve. Notice that the points, any point outside of the PPC will be out of the question, meaning right now, given our resource, three engineers, it is impossible for us to produce any point outside of the PPC. Say if you want three pizza and nine robots, that's out of the question. So the production possibility curve also tells us the idea of scarcity. Any point outside of PPC is impossible, and that tells us scarcity. And also notice that any point inside the PPC is possible, but also suggests idle resources or unemployment in this case. So for example, you see a point 1, 3, meaning we have one pizza and three robots. That means one engineer is making one pizza. The other engineer is making three robots. That means there's one engineer couldn't find a job at either the kitchen or the factory. So we have unemployment. Therefore, you can see the production possibility curve tells us many things. Opportunity cost, that's a slope. Scarcity, meaning outside of the PPC, is out of the question. And inside PPC tells us unemployment. Now we're going to switch a gear and talk about when we're going to see a bow-shaped production possibility curve. So suppose in the society, instead of three engineers, we have one engineer, one economics professor, and one chef. So you can see the engineer in 1 hour, it's the same as before. The engineer can produce either one pizza and no robots, or three robots and no pizza. What about economics professor? She is also a mom, so she knows how to cook and she knows math well. So in 1 hour, she can produce either two pizza and no robots, or two robots and no pizza. What about the chef? The chef is good at cooking. So in each hour, the chef can produce either three pizzas and no robot, or one robot and no pizza. So in this case, you could see if we have all the workers making pizza, then we can have 1 + 2 + 3, 6 pizzas and no robots. But if the three workers are only making robots, then we can have 3 + 2 + 1, 6 robots, but no pizza. Now imagine we start with this point where all the workers are making robots. So we're all hungry, and that's not ideal. So suppose we're going to send one worker from the factory from making robots to make pizza. Then we're going to send the chef first because the chef is very good at making pizza. So the chef is going to move from the factory to the kitchen. So in that case, the chef is not making robots anymore. So we're moving down, but then we're going to get three pizzas in the society. So we're moving to the right. So the new point is 3, 5, meaning we have three pizzas and five robots. So you can see we get three pizza at the cost of sacrificing one robot. And therefore, at this point, you can see our opportunity cost of one pizza is equal to 1/3 of a robot. Why? Because we get three pizza at the cost of one robot, and therefore the cost of one pizza is equal to only 1/3 of a robot. So now we're at this point. Suppose we're still hungry and we want to send one more worker to make pizza. At this time, we have only two workers to send, and we're going to send the economics professor because she is better at making pizza than the engineer. So she goes to the kitchen to make pizza, then we're going to move down. We're sacrificing two robots, but we're gaining two pizzas. And therefore, the opportunity cost of one pizza is equal to one robot because 2 / 2 = 1. So you can see the opportunity cost of a pizza has been increasing from 1/3 to one robot. Now suppose we're at this point, we have five pizza and three robots. If we're still hungry, then we have to send the last worker, engineer, from the factory to the kitchen to make pizza. Now the engineer is very good at making robots and not very good at making pizza. So our society is going to get one pizza at the cost of three robots. And therefore the opportunity cost of one pizza is equal to three robots. So again, you can see opportunity cost is increasing again from 1/3 to 1 to 3. And you can see that bow-shaped production possibility curve is more realistic to the real world. So this is why we have different shapes of production possibility curves. So I hope this helps, and I'll see you next time.